Now let us see K-maps or Karnaugh maps. Switching functions can generally be simplified by using algebraic techniques. However, two problems arise when algebraic procedures are being used. Why? Because the procedures are difficult to apply in a systematic way, and also it is difficult to tell when you have arrived at a minimum solution. So that means, given a Boolean expression, so they might give a very lengthy Boolean expression. They will ask you to solve the problem, and they will be asking you to minimize this Boolean expression. So there are certain techniques, or you say algebraic techniques, to solve these kinds of problems. So that kind of problems you may have already done in your PU classes, or maybe in the basic electronics. But you might not have studied certain techniques like K-maps or Quinn-McCloskey method, which makes you to solve such Boolean expressions in a very simple manner. Okay, so usually when you apply the algebraic techniques, you are coming across two main problems. That is, the procedures may be difficult to apply in a systematic manner, or you may feel very lengthy expressions to minimize it or to make it a simple minimum solution. So another difficulty is, it is difficult to tell when you have arrived at a minimum solution. So there might be some confusion there. So to avoid such things, you have some more approaches that you are going to study in this semester, that is K-maps and Quinn-McCloskey methods. Okay, the K-map method and the Quinn-McCloskey procedures used to overcome these difficulties by providing systematic methods for simplifying switching functions. The K-maps are usually used, or you say it is a tool for simplifying the simplifying and manipulating the switching functions of three or four variables. So whenever you have problems with three or four variables, you can go for K-maps. K-maps. So under K-maps topic, you have minimum forms of switching functions. So this is the subheading, minimum forms of switching functions. So let us see the topic. So when a function is realized using AND and OR gates, the cost of realizing the function is directly related to the number of gates and gate inputs used. So that means the cost of realizing the function, that means the cost required to implement the function is directly proportional to the number of gates and gate inputs used. So if suppose the gate inputs are high, or you say the AND gates or gates are, the numbers are high, okay, so then if you are trying to implement that particular gates, the cost also will be high. So when the gate number of gates are high and gate inputs are high, the cost of implementing such functions are also high. So we need to reduce the cost now. So we go for K-maps. K-map techniques developed that lead directly to minimum cost two level circuits, that is composed of AND and OR gates. An expression consisting of sum of product terms corresponds directly to two level circuit composed of a group of AND gates feeding a single OR gate. So already you have seen what is sum of products. So product is nothing but you have AND gates. So sum of product means you are combining the AND gates, and finally you are giving those outputs to the outputs coming from the AND gate to the OR gate. So later from OR gate you will be getting the final output. So you have an expression consisting of sum of product terms corresponds directly to the two level circuit. Two level circuit means you'll be having, finally you'll be having a AND gate and also OR gate in the next level. So one level you will be having AND gates, then in the next level you will be having OR gate. That is called two level circuit. Okay, so your sum of products will be finally the two level circuit consisting of AND gates and then the OR gates. Similarly, when you have a product of some expression, it will correspond to two level, again the two level circuit composed of OR gates feeding to the next level single AND gate. So your expression may be in terms of sum of product or product of sum, it will be finally the two level circuit. So therefore, to find the minimum cost two level AND OR circuits, we must find minimum expressions in sum of products or product of sum form. Minimum forms of switching functions. A minimum sum of products expression for a function is defined as a sum of product terms which has minimum number of terms and all of those expressions which have the same minimum number of terms has a minimum number of literals. So that means when you solve a particular Boolean expression and you try to minimize the Boolean expression, that time find the final product whatever you get, or what the final result whatever you get, should have minimum number of terms as well as the minimum number of literals. So that is a final aim for when you solve any particular Boolean expression. So here the minimum sum of products corresponds directly to a minimum two level gate circuit which has minimum number of gates and minimum number of gate inputs. That means finally when you implement that particular expression, the final expression, the expression has to lead to a minimum number of gates as well as minimum number of gate inputs. Okay, so two level gate circuit means it will be finally with AND OR circuit or AND circuit. Okay, so you are talking about sum of products. So first level you will be having AND gate, AND gate, and next level you will be having OR gate. So minimum number of gate inputs to the AND gates you should have, and the number of gates also should be very less. So that is the final aim of this minimum forms, is it? So unlike the mean term expansion for a function, the minimum sum of products is not necessarily unique. That is, given a function, it may have two different minimum sum of product forms, each with same number of terms and same number of literals. That means when you solve the particular problem and finally you get some result, so each of you may get different results, but which one is right? Which one is right? You may think, if you solve the sum of products forms, everyone may get end up with different answers. But which is right answer? See, your expression should finally have same number of terms and same number of literals. So some of your expressions may be very lengthy, so then you cannot say there is a minimum sum of product form or a minimum sum of products, is it? So everyone has to get same number of terms and same number of literals, so then we can say that the expression is fine, or the expression is right. Okay, given a mean term expansion, the minimum sum of products form can often be obtained by following procedure. So what procedure we can follow? So you need to combine terms by using uniting theorem. So that means in the uniting theorem, we have, suppose if you have the terms as xy bar plus xy, then you can write it as x itself. okay, only one single x. So do this thing repeatedly to eliminate as many literals as possible. A given term may be used more than once because x plus x is equal to x itself. So here y bar plus this particular y gets cancelled, is it? So that's why we have x plus x is equal to finally x itself. So next thing is, you have to eliminate redundant terms. Already we know what is redundant term. Example we have given in the previous slide. How you can eliminate these redundant terms in the expression? That is by using some theorems. Okay. So here, the consensus theorem is mainly used for simplifying Boolean expressions, and also this theorem is used to eliminate redundant terms from the Boolean expressions. Okay, so already you know what is meant by redundant term. So extra term you may have in a Boolean expression, we call it as redundant term, so which can be eliminated from the given Boolean expression. So here take one example, xy plus x bar z plus yz. So you want to minimize this expression. So how to minimize this particular expression? So here the term yz is redundant. We call this term yz is redundant here, and it can be eliminated to form the equivalent expression xy plus x bar z. So how this term is being eliminated? So we are using the consensus theorem here. The term that was eliminated is referred to as consensus term. Okay, so here yz is being eliminated, that term we call it as consensus term. Given a pair of terms for which a variable appears in one term and the complement of that variable in another, the consensus term is formed by multiplying the two original terms together, leaving out the selected variable and its complement. So here, given a pair of terms for which variable appears in one term, okay, and the complement of that variable is another. So here, x if we consider one term, so the complement of the other that term is x bar. So here this is the another that is x bar is the another variable, or we call it as the complement of the variable which we have selected. So what is the consensus term? How we can form the consensus term? Consensus term is formed by multiplying the two original terms together, leaving out the selected variable and its complement. So we have selected x here. Why? Because we have x bar also together in that expression. So that is a selected variable. So leave out that selected variable. What is left out? Left out is yz. Yz is the term we are left out with. So yz is considered as the redundant term here. Okay. So that is based on the consensus theorem, we have selected yz. So similarly, if you consider some other example, for example, the consensus of AB, you want to give the term for consensus of AB term. So how you can form AB and A bar C? So how you can form that? So if you see that AB and A bar C, so you need to select A variable. Why? Because you have another term there, that is A bar along with A, is it? So that is what you are going to select, one variable. What is left out? BC. So BC is the redundant term or the consensus term here. And the next example, if you take the consensus of ABD and B bar D E bar, so how do you select the consensus of these two variables, ABD and B bar D E bar? So that is, if you see that terms, if you see these two terms here, बी हैज वी बार इज इट एंड ऑल्सो द अदर टर्म विच हैज बीन कॉम्प्लीमेंटेड यू डोंट सी एनीथिंग हियर सो इट्स फाइनली यू आर लेफ्ट विथ AD consensus term here which are left out is AD and DE bar is it so that is equal to ADE bar okay so ADE bar is a consensus term so next term you have consensus term of AB bar D and A bar BD bar so how do you get the consensus term for this particular thing so B bar and B is being see B is being complemented so you can see B bar also here B and B bar and D also has been complemented D changes to D bar and A also is being complemented A changes has changed to A bar so nothing is left out no redundant term is being left out there to take it as a consensus term so that's why Nothing is being left out. Everything has a complemented form. So that's why the consensus term is zero. Nothing is there. No consensus term in this case. In the third case. Okay. So you have understood what is meant by consensus term. So let us use this particular terms for solving. So let us consider one problem here. Find the minimum sum of products expression for f of a, b, c. So that is equal to mean term summation of 0, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7. So here they are asking you to find the minimum sum of product form. Okay. Or the expression they want. So you have to convert this mean term form that is this particular expression whatever they have written you have to convert it into a boolean expression so here you can see that in this particular problem you can see that f you can write the same expression f is equal to abc so these are the it is a three variable function it is so you can write the same thing as f is equal to a bar b bar c bar that means mean term 0 they have written here okay mean term 0 can be written as a bar b bar c bar next is mean term 1 that can be written as a bar b bar c or you say in other terms it is actually the value is 0 0 1 okay and next thing you have 2 mean term 2 so that can be written as a bar b c bar and also a b bar c plus similarly for the sixth term you can write it as mean term 6 a b c bar and at last seventh mean term can be written as a b c so in this particular example they are going to eliminate these terms by using the consensus theorem okay some of the terms can be cancelled using consensus theorem so already have in the previous slide I've said about consensus theorem So, using that, if you are going to eliminate some of the terms, you can reduce the expression in this manner. So, here, consider these two terms. First, A bar, B bar, C bar, and also next you have A plus A bar, B bar, C. So, if you see this one term, that is C is being in a complemented form here. C bar you have. And next you can see that it's C itself. So that if you are taking the left out terms are A bar, B bar. So that is a consensus term. So next you have next thing is if you are considering the A bar, B bar, C and A, B bar, C. The term whatever is left out is B bar. And C. So here in this particular things, can see that c bar plus c gets cancelled. And also here, if you are seeing, the next thing is c is kept as it is, but here a bar and a gets cancelled. And next, if you see, next consider a bar b bar a bar b c bar, and the other expression at this side you can take a b c bar. If you see that, you can take here, so a bar and a, that gets cancelled, and you remain with b c bar. And similarly for the other next expression, if you are taking a b c bar and a b c, if you see that a b remains and c bar plus c gets cancelled. So here you remain with only three variables, but the literals are more here. How many literals you have? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 literals you have. That means it's a little bit more literals are there. So actually when you solve the minimum sum of products expression, our final aim is to get the minimum literals. Okay, finally you have to get minimum literals. So in other way also you can solve the same problem. So many students solve in different manner. So first, here we have applied consensus theorem, but it is not going to eliminate all the terms here or literals. It's not going to minimize the literals. So that's why we are going to solve this in another manner. So so let's see that. So let us combine the terms in a different manner that leads to directly to a minimum sum of products. So we are going to try to solve this particular sum of product in a different manner. So let's see that. So here consider again that same problem. We have written the same expression again here. F is equal to a bar b bar c bar plus a bar b bar c plus a bar b c bar plus a b bar c plus a b bar a b c bar plus a b c. So if you see that again, I take some other terms to combine and I try to eliminate some of the terms. So this manner, if I try, see here, I take a bar b bar one term, but that same step is being followed in the previous problem also. So here c bar plus c gets cancelled, so that it is redundant term. Next, if you combine your a bar b c bar plus a b c bar, if you try to combine that way, you remain with the b c bar. And the next thing is you try to combine a b bar c and a b c, you remain with a c. So here in this manner, if you are combining, you remain with only how many terms, how many literals? 6 literals. So in the previous problem, when you solved the problem using consensus theorem, you had obtained 8 literals. So if you see that, you can see in the problem 8 literals were present, but I tried to solve in a different manner, you got 6 literals, that is a bar b bar b c bar and a c. Variables are same, minimum variables you have, that is a b c, but 6 literals you have. So this is if you say that which one is more right, the second problem is more right because you got less literals in the second problem. Okay, same expression, but second problem leads to your minimum literals. Product of sums expression for a function is defined as product of sum terms which has minimum number of terms and also minimum number of literals. So the rule what you have applied for this forming the minimum sum of products expression is applied here also. Okay, same rules are followed to get a minimum product of sums expression. And unlike max term expansion, the minimum product of sums form of a function is not necessarily unique. So this thing also is same same thing is applied in the sum of products method also. Okay, minimum product of sums can often be obtained by uniting theorem. So what is uniting theorem says is x plus y into x plus y bar is equal to x. So here y and y bar gets cancelled, so that's why finally you remain only with x. So the mean terms and products are represented in algebraic notation or binary notations. So you can express any mean term and the products in different manner. So you may represent in algebraic notation, sometimes you may represent in binary notations also. Whatever you follow, it is all same. So when you try to solve the problem, so here the first four variables example, so you have here two examples mainly. First example, if you consider here how the term gets cancelled, you let us see that. Okay, here the in the first example, if you see here a b bar c d bar plus a b bar c d, so that example if you are going to take, you get answer as a b bar c. That means d bar plus b gets cancelled and you remain with only three terms there. So the first four variable example below illustrates these four mean terms, and the second four the products containing three literals. The dash indicates here the missing variables. So here, whenever you write the expression, Boolean expression, that is here if you are going to see a b bar c d bar, so that expression can be expressed in binary notation as 1 0 1 0. Okay, and again a b bar c d can be represented as 1 0 1 1, is it? So now here when 0 changes to 1, so that means here you can see that d bar changes to d, is it? Or d bar plus d gets cancelled. Okay, so that you can represent by dash. So whatever the term which has you have cancelled, you represent it with dash. So finally you remain with 1 0 1 dash. And also another expression you have taken, Boolean expression, that is one more example, a b bar c plus a b c, so that is also equal to a c. So here the term which is getting cancelled is b bar with p. Okay, so that is getting cancelled. So if same expression can be represented in binary notation, it can be represented as 101 dash plus 111 dash. So here dash is the missing variable, we have already have said. Missing variable means it d we have not represented, that's why we have written it as dash there. Okay, and whichever the term gets that's cancelled, b bar with p gets cancelled, right? So that term also I can represent with dash. So what is the final expression, Boolean expression? You remain with only ac. So a you can write it as 1, b is not there, it's got cancelled, is it? So that's why you represent with dash, and c with 1 again, d is not there, so again we represent with dash. So one note you take, note that mean terms only combine if they differ in one variable, and products only combine if they have dashes in the same position and differ in one other variable. Okay, so that is the note, key note you have to take.